Did the Supremes get back together?
Girl, you've been gone too long.
Ooh. reminiscing with us. Pleased to say that the Motor City label has asked us to do an album. This next song, thank you, is going to be featured on our forthcoming album.
Love. Four simple little letters, and they say so much. Did you know that love is the deepest and the strongest emotion in the whole wide world? That's right. Love is what keeps a family together. Love is what keeps a marriage together. A bond that can never be broken if it's really real. Love is like the greatest love song ever sung. Ha! The greatest poem ever read. Love. And sometimes when you're riding on that cloud, you wonder, can this go on forever? And sometimes you get a fear in your heart. Can the bubble be burst?
will the fairy tale end? We ask you, simply, how do you make it go on forever?
Do we keep the music playing? How do we make it last? How do we keep the song from fading too fast?
The music.
little Daniel Colton, who says, and Steve's son.
Now, I want to tell you how a great love, it will light up, it will surely light. Your darkest hours, ooh, and all you have to do is believe.
Music, just in love, dancing through the air. Englishman responsible for getting all the Motown acts together. But ladies and gentlemen, how could we let the evening end without introducing our dear friend? Let's bring Edwin Starr back to the stage.
For this wonderful opportunity.
Yeah.
Right now, this tour that we're doing now with Ian Levine is something that I think is going to be one to remember, to be remembered, because it's really, it's putting together some fabulous people, people that really can make good music, and that's what Motown was all about. When all is said and done, it was about the music, the chart busters, and they had a lot of them.
Don't you hear the wind blowing?
They had a vision of having great talent, and there were so many of them that were great at the same time. It was hard to pay attention to all of them at the same time. And even though I thought that they should have, I think that they probably didn't have enough, personnel for that. Mm-hmm. And so some people got to be, you know, they felt like they were neglected. And probably some of those people you named felt that way and left feeling that way, you know. So
I grew up in Motown during the Motown days in Detroit, and as you speak of the negative and positive, I experienced both sides of that living in Detroit and hearing what was going on, the feedback from the layperson as well as the entertainers at Motown. And there were some who had the same negative feelings towards Diana. And I don't know if they were justified or not. I'm not going to comment on that. But we've all grown and matured. And like Gene mentioned, some people were sort of put in the background for others to be pushed ahead. And maybe Berry Gordy had the insight to see that some had, even though they were all talented, some just had a little bit more than others. And Diana's shadow is a bitty, pretty big shadow to fill, even though she's a little lady. but even if you are in her shadow, it's still an honor.
Baby, I'm aware of where you go. Each time you leave my door.
We've got the Supremes back together again as much as is humanly possible, basically because Mary Wilson and Motown are in litigation over the name, and no one person can call themselves the Supremes. And we have them together as a group of ex-ladies from the Supremes called Jean, Sherry and Linda of the Supremes.
Wonderful to be able to get back together and to embark on another side of this career. I mean, it's very few groups that you can honestly say they can go back and grab a career all these years later.
Where you go, each time you leave.
Strong positive and negative points about Motown, but I imagine the positive would definitely outnumber the negative, because first of all, I'm a mature man now, and I'm not too concerned about the past. I'm more concerned about the future. I'm also concerned about the fact that a young gentleman from Blackpool, England, named Ian Levine, has shown enough interest because of his youth in the artists, and has shown enough interest to really put himself out on the limb to try to develop and sort of bring some of these people back on the scene. Now, the way I feel about some of the statements that have been made around England about Ian Levine, if I could get my hands on these people, it'd be pitiful, you know, because first of all, I've heard statements such as he is nourishing a lot of has-beens and so forth. Now, to whoever that person was, I'd like to say this. It's better to be a has-been than never to have been at all.
Before you break. You
Well, thank you.
I really appreciate about live performances is the energy that you can have when you're performing live, you know? It's a different energy that you have when you're performing live than when you're doing something, you know, recorded, because you can do it over and over and over, and it can be a drag, and you got to try to keep the energy up. But when you're on stage, it's a one-time thing. And even if the audience is not right there with you, you know that this is what you have to do, so you have to create your own energy.
The only thing about performing live is that once you make a mistake, that's it. But the trick is to keep on smiling. Regardless of what happens, just keep on smiling. Even if you fall flat on your face, which I have done, I have fallen on stage and I have fallen off the stage, but I kept on smiling.
The energy that you need when you're on stage is really something that you have to talk yourself into. I know for myself, when I'm doing all this, the preparation is what gets my energy going. You know, it gets my adrenaline going. You know, I start looking at myself and I go, wow, this is Linda Lawrence. You know, before, who the heck was it? You know what I mean?
So I'm putting highlights on my nose so it makes the nose appear nice and straight. A little highlight on my chin. Oh, makeup techniques. What am I supposed to be talking about anyway?
Hello. I love that one. That is so cute. I think that's adorable, I really do. He's funny, Martin, you know? The bass player, he is really funny. No, really, the fairly, you know, proper way of saying, hello, cheerio, you know, it's all that sort of rot, you know, darling. I love it. Rarely you hear cheerio, really. I mean, you think about Cheerios that you eat.
Hey, we're very much on top of getting
And you know, the show is wonderful.
It is.
It's wonderful. Mm-hmm. I'm just hoping more and more people can see it so they can appreciate, you know, what we're really doing. I really do.
Linda, all is free!
I think they were innovative. I believe that Supremes came along at a time where there was just no other group like the Supremes. And although there were other groups, you know, the Ronettes, the Chantels, and so forth, but the Supremes were unique in that they had their own sound. Motown sound was really becoming a new thing at the time, and the quality of their work was quite good. And of course, the dresses were wonderful.
Have the right to love, and we've got the right to spread a little bit of that love around.